Ya.
Thank you, Lord. I only wish my sons were half as brave as you. I'll see to it that we hear this tale and know what it is to be a true hero.
Who could have done such a thing?
Come on, come on! I've much to say! Welcome! I have everything you'll ever need.
Believe your eyes!
I have exactly what you need. For today only, I've decided to reduce prices on everything.
Welcome.
Now, I have everything you'll ever need. Come, people. Come see what I have to offer.
Everything's new. Everything perfectly priced. Finest wares in all the land. Come, people! Come! See what I have to offer! You won't believe your eyes!
Come, people! Come see what I have to offer!
Acting like a child!
Don't hurt me, please! Praise be Salah Adin! He has found the strength to stand in defense of our great civilization. Make no mistake, it is our very existence we are fighting for. The infidel king will see us all wiped from the world. We must resist. We must.
Hurt himself.
When he does, I won't help him.
Tamir drove a caravan in those days between Damascus and Jerusalem. But recent business had been poor. It seemed there were none in Jerusalem who wanted what he had, fruits and vegetables from nearby farms. It was just before Hattin. The Saracens were low on food and in desperate need of resupply, but there was no relief in sight. As Tamir drove his caravan north, he came across the Saracen leader and his starving men. Most fortunate. for them both, each having something the other wanted. Just before that the Saracens were low on food and in desperate need of resupply. But there was no relief in sight. Damir drove a caravan in those days between Damascus and Jerusalem. But recent business had been poor. It seemed there were none in Jerusalem who wanted what he had. Fruits and vegetables from nearby farms.
Strange, I've never seen someone do that before.
Altair, it is good to see you, and in one piece.
You as well, friend.
I am sorry for your troubles. Think nothing of it. A few of your brothers were here earlier, in fact. Oof, if you'd heard the things they said, I'm certain you'd have slain them where they stood.
It's quite all right.
Yes, you've never been one for the creed, have you?
Is that all?
I'm sorry. Sometimes I forget myself. What business brings you to Damas?
A man named Tamir. Al-Muallim takes issue with the work he does. I meant to end it. Now tell me where to find him.
Surely you remember how to track an enemy.
Of course. Learn where he will be and when. But that sort of work is best left for... I understand.
Go and search the city, determine what he's planning and where he works. Preparation makes the victor.
What can you tell me of him?
Tamir makes his living as a black market merchant, so the Souk district should be your destination. I would suggest you seek out the following places. A small souk northeast of here, the madrasa to our east, and in the gardens north of this bureau. Focus on these places and he should become well known to you.
I assume you want me to return to you when this is done.
Yes. Come back to me. I'll give you Al-Mualim's marker and you'll give us Tamir's life.
As you wish.
Remember, Altair, if you find yourself in trouble and the city turned against you, return to the bureau. I can shelter you from the storm. Be warned, though, if your enemies are too close, my door will remain closed until you've lost them. Do you understand?
Yes. To bring the enemy inside would compromise the Brotherhood.
Very well. Off you go.
The man his food. And when the battle was finished, the Saracen leader saw to it that the merchant was repaid 1,000 times. As Tamir drove his caravan north, he came across the Saracen leader and his starving men. Most fortunate for them both, each having something the other wanted. And so Tamir left, riding north and wondering what would become of his supplies. For soon, he would surely spoil. That should have been the end of this tale and the poor man's life. But fate intended otherwise. Tamir drove a caravan in those days between Damascus and Jerusalem. But recent business had been poor. It seemed there were none in Jerusalem who wanted what he had, fruits and vegetables from nearby farms. So Tamir gave the man his food, and when the battle was finished, the Saracen leader saw to it that the merchant was repaid 1,000 times. As Tamir drove his caravan north, he came across the Saracen leader and his starving men. Most fortunate for them both, each having something the other wanted. Tamir drove a caravan in those days between Damas and Jerusalem. But recent business had been poor. It seemed there were none in Jerusalem who wanted what he had, fruits and vegetables from nearby farms. Some say Were it not for Tamir, Salah ad-Din's men would have surely turned on him. Could be we won the battle because of that man.
I don't know you. Leave me alone.
What is it?
You seem to know quite a bit about Tamir. Tell me what he's planning.
I know only the stories I tell, nothing more.
A pity. There's no reason to let you live if you've nothing to offer in return.
Wait, wait! There is one thing.
Continue.
He is preoccupied as of late. He oversees the production of many, many weapons.
What of it? They're meant for Salah ad-Din. This does not help me, which means it does not help you.
No, stop, listen! Not Salah ad-Din. They're for someone else. The crests these arms bear, they are different, unfamiliar. It seems Tamir supports another, but I know not who.
Is that all?
Yes, yes. I've told you everything I know.
Then it's time for you to rest.
How reckless can one get?
Oh, my.
There is no reason for doing that.
Safety and peace, Altair. I trust you are looking for information to aid you in your strike against Tamir. I fear I've nothing to offer. But Bahir might. He shouldn't be too far from here.
Please, someone do something.
Thief! You are filth!
Let me go!
I've got it.
So comes the English king and his infidel army. They leave horrors in their wake. Salah ad-Din rides to meet him.
So they've sent you, eh? An interesting choice, though not my place to judge. The Rafiq has asked me to observe the souk that Tamir calls home. Here's what I have learned. There's a group of troublemakers who gather around its southeastern exit. They and the guards do not get along. Find a way to earn their friendship, and they'll surely be of service to you.
Fighting for what we believe in. There is no greater glory than this.
You look like you need something. You'll find it here. I'm sure of it.
Now, why is he doing that?
You'll find everything here, my friend. There's nothing I do not have. Like what you see? Good day, my friend. Is there anything I can help you with? I've got it.
You dare steal in my presence? That will cost you your life.
Something tough to
you won't find better prices anywhere.
That won't happen here. What do you want?
You won't find better prices anywhere.
Do you understand?
Yes. I am to deliver the letter to your merchant friend.
And you know who to see?
The same man as always.
Do not think to betray my presence in this city. We have many eyes, many ears.
And many arms, yes. Good for silencing those who say too much. I know this well. You have my word.
Good. Then be quick about it. Time is short.
Nothing I do not have.
Move.
I'll have your hand for that!
Then come see me! My merchant life is worth it!
What is that man doing?
Wise, which is why you've come to me.
Go away!
I'm telling you, it's rats!
No, it's children. I hear them laughing.
Rats or children? Either way, it's bad for business. All that noise!
Someone needs to get up on those beams and clear them out.
I wonder how they're getting up there.
Must be through the central courtyard.
Then we should ask the guard to have a look.
Ah, they're all much too busy polishing the backside of their master.
No, well, there's more. Much more.
Why? You ever see
someone? Which is why you come to me.
I don't understand.
Come see what I have to offer. Everything's new. Everything perfect.
The Shaitan is everywhere. Watching. Waiting. He tempts us always. Be strong.
Is that man doing?
Thief, I'll have your hand for that! Thief! You are filth!
Why are you doing this? What have I done?
You dare steal in my presence? That will cost you your life!
Help!
Please help! Altair, welcome! Welcome!
I've done what you asked. Now give me the marker.
First things first. Tell me what you know.
Tamir rules over the Souk El Salah. He makes his fortune selling arms and armor and is supported by many in this endeavor. Blacksmiths, traders, financiers. He's the largest death dealer in the land.
And have you devised a way to rid us of this blight?
A meeting is being arranged at Souk El Salah to discuss an important sale. They say it's the largest deal Tamir has ever made. He'll be distracted with his work. That's when I'll strike.
Your plan seems solid enough. I give you leave to go.
Let Al-Mualim's will be done. You may rest here until you are ready.
Fast forwarding memory to a more recent one.
Some of my wares.
Let
me show you everything I have.
Please, someone do something.
You break it, you buy it. You do not want to do that again.
Our family is sick in dying. Could you spare a few coins? Just a little money, I beg of you.
No, you just have a look.
I have no interest in the calculations. The numbers change nothing. Your men have failed to fill the order, which means I have failed my client.
We need more time.
This is the excuse of a lazy or incompetent man. Which are you?
Neither.
What I see says otherwise. Now, tell me, what do you intend to do to solve this problem of ours? These weapons are needed now.
I see no solution. The men work day and night, but your client requires so much, and the destination. It is a difficult route.
Would that you could produce weapons with the same skill as you produce excuses.
I have done all I can.
It is not enough.
Then perhaps you ask too much.
Too much? I gave you everything. Without me, you would still be charming serpents for coin. All I ask in return was you fill the orders I bring you, and you say I ask too much? You dare disrespect me?
Peace, Tamir. I meant no insult.
Then you should have kept your mouth shut.
No, stop!
Stop? I'm just getting started.
No! Stop!
You came into my souk, stood before my men, and dared to insult me! Must learn your place!
No. Leave the bottle. Let this be a lesson to the rest of you. Think twice before you tell me something cannot be done. Now get back to work.
Please, can't we spare something? I'm poor and sick and hungry. Please, sir, have any money?
Could I interest you in this?
No? Pathetic. Well, absolutely pathetic. Where did you learn your craft?
Which is why you've come to me. Tired of never finding anything useful at the other merchants.
Be at peace. You'll pay for this. You and all your kind.
It seems you're the one pays now, my friend. You'll not profit from suffering any longer.
You think me some petty death dealer, suckling at the breast of war? A strange target, don't you think? Why me, when so many others do the same?
You believe yourself different, then?
Oh, but I am. for I serve a far nobler cause than mere profit. Just like my brothers.
Brothers?
Ah, but he thinks I act alone. I am but a piece. A man with a part to play. You'll come to know the others soon enough. They won't take kindly to what you've done.
Good. I look forward to ending their lives as well.
Such pride. It will destroy you, child.
Me of your victory, Altair. You have my gratitude and my respect.
Thank you.
It is a shame that the other assassins continue to hold you in such poor regard.
Rafik, I do not care what the others think of me.
As you wish, Altair. You should bring news of your victory to Al-Mualim. I'm certain he has more work for you to do.
Fast forwarding memory to a more recent one.